Good morning, friends. So today we're heading to the African market at Den Haag, The Hague, as it is known in English, which is like the capital of Netherlands. We're hoping to buy a few stuff like from African stores that we can't get here in Rotterdam. And I'm excited because it's my first time there. And so I'm going to take you guys with me, of course. So let's go. So apparently what we're coming to is not like a market, it's a warehouse that sells imported stuff. So we're actually like in a warehouse district, and there are lots of big stores where you can buy stuff in like wholesale. So yeah, I'm going to show you guys now. So far I won't say this is an African market because they sell things from Africa, Suriname, and I think like the Middle East. But it's a good place to come if you want to buy in bulk, because everything is literally in cartons and boxes, so you can really stock up for a long time with your staples. There's rice, like different types of rice, basmati, all types of rice. I'm really impressed by the selection here. There's pretty much everything that you need to make your meals here. Now we'll find out about the prices when we're about to be, because I can't see prices anywhere, but we shall see. I'll let you guys know if it's affordable or not. Hi guys, so we're back from the market now. We just got back. I couldn't continue filming in the warehouse because it was so cold. Like the temperature in the warehouse was pretty much the same as the temperature outside. Please ignore the background noise. I'm boiling water because I need to defrost. I am so cold. It's so cold today. But it was a very good shopping experience. The prices there were really good. And yeah, for most things actually the prices were very good. Like I said earlier, I wouldn't say it's an African store, but I would say that it's a one-stop shop for people from Africa, from the Middle East, from India, to find the items that they cannot find in the everyday grocery store. And the prices were really, really good, except for Horlicks. I need to understand why Horlicks is so expensive. We carried a six-pack box of Horlicks, right? Because we were so excited to see Horlicks, and thinking that it was going to be cheap, only for us to pay for Horlicks. And Horlicks, the price of the Horlicks plus tax was like 43 euros for six packs. Like, kilo day, kilo reason. We returned it with immediate alacrity. But that was the only expensive thing that we bought there. Basmati rice. We bought 10 kg of Lakila basmati rice for 23 euros. That is a steal. The last time we tried to buy rice close to the house here, 5 kg of basmati rice, Lakila, they were selling it at 20 euros. So imagine us getting 10 kgs for 23 euros. It was really good. The prices there were really good. We bought a lot of stuff. I wanted to do an unboxing and unpacking, but I'm tired. I'm very sorry. I'm super tired. I can't do it right now, and I need to put a lot of stuff in the freezer. But I would say that it's a very good place for you to go bulk shopping if you live in the Rotterdam, Den Haag area. It's a very good place for you to go. You will get your money's worth. But I advise that if you're planning to go there, go ready with your money and go with the car. That's the easiest. Like, go with a car so you can buy as much things as possible. It makes sense for bulk shopping, not to just go and buy one item and go. If you want to go there, go to with the intention of buying in bulk. We just went there today to just see what it looks like, and we still bought a lot of stuff. But going forward, now we know that whenever we are going there, I'm going to make it maybe twice in a year to go there and buy whatever I need in bulk and wrap it up. But yeah, very good, good prices. We got a lot of things. I really wish I could show you guys. I'm sorry, it's too much. But we bought gari, we bought semo, we bought pando yam, we bought plantain fufu, we bought sweet corn. And that sweet corn even bust my brain past, because we bought a box of sweet corn with 16 pieces, sorry, with 32 pieces for 3 euros or so. Meanwhile, if you want to buy one pack of that corn here in the city, they are selling that one pack for like 4 euros. Mad thing. But yeah, we got some sweet corn, lots of sweet corn. We bought chicken, we bought beef, we bought a big pack of sausages that had like I think 12 packs. Everything there is in like big like multiple quantities, right? So we bought quite a good number of things, and I think even for the next few months we are good with the things that we bought. But yeah, maybe the next time I do a big shopping haul when I go there, I'll make it a whole thing and show you guys. But I'm so tired, like I'm cold, so I just want to drink some tea and lie down. But yeah, this was a very long explanation for nothing. But yeah, that, I just thought to update you guys on the experience. So at a lot at deal, but it was good, sure. I wasn't disappointed with things that we bought. But yeah, let me go and drink tea and defrost. See you later. Bye.
Hey guys. So today I'm going to be putting up my first ever Christmas tree. Is that English correct? First ever Christmas tree. You know what I mean, Sha? I've never put up a Christmas tree ever. And this is the first time. My kids are getting to that age, especially my son, where he's more aware of the holidays, and he has been asking if we're going to have a Christmas tree. I wasn't planning to this year. I don't know why I'm like this, but so anyways, I got a Christmas tree and I bought the ornaments and stuff. I've had this Christmas tree for almost a week now and I've not put it up. So today is the day that I put it up, because if I continue like this, January will come and that Christmas tree will still be in the box. So yeah, we are doing that today. Let's go.
finally finished fluffing up the tree, and I want to use this opportunity to call out everybody that I've seen on social media that has put up their trees that make it seem like it's a walk in the park. You people are liars, because why did I just spend the past 30, 35, 40 minutes fluffing out the tree? I have not even started with the ornament at all. Setting up a tree is definitely a labor of love, because if not that, I'm not a quitter. I would have just said, you know what, this is a wrap. And now, on to the fun part, decorations. Yay! Let's go. So I kind of have a concept that I want to go with. I saw a video on Instagram that I'm hoping to kind of replicate with my ornaments. So let's do that. I'm excited about that. Yep.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look in the 5 and 10, glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes aglow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. A pair of hopalong boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolls that will talk and will go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go.
Thank you.
for someone that did not have an intention of getting a Christmas tree up, I definitely went crazy when I was buying a lot of the ornaments, because I bought so many things and now I don't even know where to fit them in my design. After the other stars that I just put, that I showed you guys, I'll give you a close-up. I also bought these stars, or snowflakes actually. These are snowflakes. And I don't know where to put them, because I'm thinking that this tree is starting to look like a lot. But yeah, we move, we keep going. I'm really excited. Now that I started, I'm really excited about it. So I think I'm just going to keep sticking things on until I'm done. And I'll show you guys the end. Finally done. Let me give our eyes a close-up. Looks so good. Not bad for my first tree. Not bad at all. Let me do a video with the light on.
I like it.
Yeah. I like it too.
I told me first.
This is the wreath that I just made. I'm going to put it outside the door. It's pretty simple. Straightforward. Peep my lights, my Christmas tree. Nadine.